As per request by one of the patrons on Patreon for the channel, today we're going to be making a video on how to bake ambient occlusion maps in Blender 4.2. To start off, you're going to want to make sure you have an object which you've UV unwrapped. If you're new to UV unwrapping, feel free to check out my UV unwrapping playlist, which I'm adding videos to a lot at the moment. We've already got plenty to get you this far. You can see I've got this UV here, which is what I'm going to bake onto. And I'm then going to press tab to go back into object mode. And here in the bottom left hand corner, I'm going to make sure I'm in the shader editor here. If you're not, you're probably in the timeline, in which case you can just click the clock and change it to shader editor. If you don't see anything in here, it's probably because you haven't added material yet. So to do that, you can just press plus new. Then I'm going to press shift A, and then under texture, I'm going to choose image texture. This is what I'm going to bake my ambient occlusion onto. Then I'm going to press plus new and I'm going to give it a name. I'm just going to call it ambient occlusion. Width and height will allow us to determine the resolution of the texture. I'm going to leave it at this 1K, but you can make it bigger if you like. And then I'm going to press new image. Then at the bottom here, I'm going to change color space to non-color. I'm then going to left click and drag this in between these two menus here to pull this out. And here I'm going to change to my viewport shading mode. Right now, you might be confused because despite the principal BSDF saying our base color is white, it's showing up as black here. This is because of the new updated Eevee in Blender 4.2, and we'll need to do a quick setting to fix this. Pretty simple though. All we need to do is come to my bottom right hand corner menu here called the properties menu, and I'll go to render properties, which is this one at second from the top. Then render engine, I'm going to change to Eevee, and I'm going to enable this ray tracing, and I'm going to change my max roughness to 1. You can now see that it's got the appropriate color. I'm going to change my render engine at the top here from Eevee back to cycles. This is because baking occurs in the cycles render engine. Now I'm going to come down to my render options here, and usually when we're baking we use a nice low sample count of something like 10 because baking usually doesn't need a lot of samples. However, with ambient occlusion I found it's a little bit different. This is because it does tend to have quite a bit of noise. And for that reason, I recommend using a higher sample count than 10. So I went for around 200, which is probably how I usually render my images at. If you're not satisfied with the result, you can set the max samples to something higher. Then I'm going to scroll all the way down to this option called bake, which I'm going to open up. Under bake type, I'm going to make sure I have ambient occlusion selected. It should probably be combined by default. Then you want to make sure all these settings are left unchanged. If you're unsure if you've changed them by accident, just make sure they're the same as mine. Then I'm going to make sure I've got my ambient occlusion texture here left clicked in this shader editor, and then I'm going to press bake. Great, now our bake is finished. The progress bar will finish, and if you have one of these image editors or UV editors open, you'll see the image here. I'll just scroll to scroll out, and you can see here we've got some gradient being created here from the ambient occlusion. And to actually see this, I'm first of all going to press shift A, then under input I'm going to choose texture coordinate. This is going to tell this texture here how to be mapped across the object, and since we baked our texture onto a UV, we're going to want to use the UV map coordinates to place the texture onto our cylindrical object here. I'll then plug color into base color. Now you can see we have our ambient occlusion texture being shown on our object. However, we aren't finished here. We need to now save our image. It won't be saved into Blender by default, as we need to create a new image file. So here where it says image, you need to be in a UV editor or image editor to do this. You can just left click the image button with the asterisk or star beside it, which just means it hasn't been saved. I'll left click this and then I'll choose save as, and then I'm going to choose a location on my computer, and here on the top right you can choose your file format, so you can leave it as PNG or you can make it JPEG. I'm going to leave it at PNG and then just choose save as image. Now you'll notice the star beside image has disappeared, indicating that it's been saved. If you were to rebake this, all you would need to do is press image and then save, and it will just override the last save. So you don't need to press save as every time. And yeah, that just about covers it. If you want to learn more about texture baking, make sure to check out my entire playlist on baking different types of texture maps. And make sure to subscribe if you want to see more texture baking videos in the future. Apart from that, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.